Good day, everyone. Welcome to Engineering Mathematics Review. Our topic for today is about word problem topic levers. So let's have an example for you to be able to visualize and understand this type of word problem. So let's have our first example. Our first example is number one, Mary weighted 120 pounds and sat on one end of a teeter-totter, 8 feet from the center. So what is teeter-totter? It's like a seesaw. It's a seesaw. So Jim, the other person, Jim weighted 160 pounds and sat on the other side. So how far from the fulcrum? What is fulcrum? Fulcrum is a balance point. So must Jim sit to balance Mary if the balance point is at the center of the board? Okay. So for the solution, this type of problem, we need to understand the principle behind. So the principle behind involved is that the weight times its distance from the whole room, from the fulcrum on the one side is equals to the weight times its distance from the fulcrum on the other side. So this is the equation of our lever we're going to use in this lever word problem type. Okay, so we have the data. So we have the formula. All we have to do is identify the first object and the second object and the distance of the first object and the second object with respect to the fulcrum or to the balance point. Okay, so if we do from the equation, so we substitute what is our first object, Mary, or first person, Mary. How is the weight of Mary? That is 120. So that is 120. 8 feet from the center. So 8 feet from the center. So here, so we have 8 feet and the weight of Mary is 120 pounds. Okay. So on the other side, so this is Mary and this is Jim. What is the weight of Jim? 160 pounds. And what is the distance? So that is unknown. So it's where Jim need to sit in order to balance. Okay, so that's the point of the problem. Must Jim to balance how far from the fulcrum? So this is the fulcrum. Jim sit in order to balance to balance with Mary. Okay, so doing so, using the function of your calculator, we have the answer of 6. So the distance from the fulcrum is 6 feet. So that is the point where Jim need to sit in order to balance with the weight of Mary on the other side. So that will be equilibrium. So they are balanced. Despite, for example, that is a teeter-totter, of this is Mary and this is Jim. So since since Mary is lighter, so Mary can sit far from the fulcrum, but since Jim is a bit heavier, so this is already established, so Jim need to sit closer to the fulcrum. So if this is 8 feet, for example, this is Jim, so he sit 6 feet from the fulcrum in order to have a balanced teeter-totter. Okay, I hope you understand with the problem and the principle of lever problem. Let's move to our next example. So example number two, Tim was digging up his yard to plant a garden. He hit a large rock and got a crowbar to raise the rock to the surface. The crowbar was 6 feet long and the rock was later found out to weigh 80 pounds. Tim used other rock as a fulcrum and exerted a force equal to 16 pounds on the end of the crowbar in order to raise the rock to a point of balance. So how far was the fulcrum from the 80 pound rock? So the unknown is the distance of the rock going to the fulcrum. So for the solution, same principle we're going to use. Okay, But we need to visualize first our problem. So if this team was digging and he found out a rock, so if this is team, he exerted a force of 16 pounds. So that would be your W2, that is 16 pounds. And the crowbar was 6 feet long. So the total length of our crowbar here is 6 feet. So that is the total length of the crowbar. And the rock, the first object is the rock, will weigh 80 pounds. Okay, so we have a rock. Okay, so we have a distance here. If this is the fulcrum, this is the other rock used as a fulcrum when Jim is trying to lift the rock. So if this is the fulcrum, that is the unknown. How far was the fulcrum from the 80 pound rock? So this is unknown. So that is our unknown. If we already know the total length of the crowbar, therefore on the other side, the length of this from the fulcrum, the remaining length of crowbar is what? Yes, that's correct. That is 6 minus x. So we have a complete details of our equation. We have W1, we have distance 1, that is your x. W2, that is 16 pounds, and that is 6 minus x. Okay, so let's do our part. So let's subsolve and determine the value of x. So doing so, we determine using the function of your calculator, we determine 1 feet of distance from the fulcrum going to 80 pounds. Okay, so we have 1 feet. I hope you comprehend with our solution. If you have question, just comment down below. Okay, let's move to our third example. A third example, a weight 60 pounds rests on the other end of a teeter-totter 8-foot lever and is 3 feet from the fulcrum. What weight must be placed on the other end of the lever to balance the 60 pound weight? Okay, so if you observe, the other weight is missing. So, but we have a total distance of the end to 8 feet lever and 3 feet from the fulcrum. We have a total length of the lever. So that is the total length of your teeter-totter. So here, so if you observe, the weight is 60 pound raised on the other end of an 8 feet lever. So the total distance is 8 feet and the 8 feet lever and is 3 feet from the fulcrum. So we have 3 feet here and we have 60 pounds. So in order to balance, what weight must be placed on the other end to balance a 60 pound weight? So this is our second weight. So that is our unknown. So our D2 here, since we have 3 here, so therefore our D2 is 8 minus 3. So therefore our D2 is equal to 5 feet. So using your equation, okay, so it's an interchange, so but still they are the same. So we have 5 times your unknown, W2 is your unknown, so that is, and the other side, that is 60 times the distance 3. Okay, so doing so, using the function calculator, you can solve it right away using your calculator. That is 36. So we have a 36 pounds. A weight must be weighed and placed on the other side to balance this fulcrum, to have a balanced lever with respect to its fulcrum. Okay, so I hope you understand. Let's move to our fourth example. Example number 4. So 4 girls decided to use the same teeter-totter. 2 of them weighing 50 pounds and 75 pounds respectively sat on the opposite end of the 12-foot board which had a balance point at the center. So the third girl weighing 60 pounds got on the same side as the weighing 50 pounds and sat 5 feet from the fulcrum. Where must be the fourth girl sit so that the teeter-totter is balanced if she weighs 40 pounds? Okay, so this same principle we're going to use. we just expand the equation since there are four objects or there are four little girls playing teeter-totter. Okay, so if you visualize, there are four. So this is our fourth girl. So where she need to sit from the fulcrum, that is our unknown distance. Okay, so let's check with our parameters. So we have 50 pounds, our first object, and the second object or the second girl sat on the other end, 75 pounds. So sat on the opposite end of a 12 foot board. So the total length is 12 foot board. Okay, so with a balance point at the center, therefore they have an equal distance. So here we have 6 feet, and on the other side there are 6 feet, so they're in the equal distance. So the third girl weighing 60 pounds got on the same side weighing 50 pounds. So 50, the third girl weighed 60 pounds and sat 5 feet from the fulcrum. So this is 5 feet from the fulcrum. So this is the fulcrum of our teeter-totter, or the center, or the balance point. And the third girl, which must sit teeter-totter to balance, if she weighs 40. So this is 40. So the distance from the fulcrum with our fourth girl is our x, or our unknown. Okay, so that is our d3 in our equation. That is our unknown. Substitute the given attributes, then use your calculator, shift solve. The answer is 3.75. Therefore, the distance between the fulcrum going to the fourth girl is 3.75, or 3¾ feet. Okay, so if you have question, just comment down below. Let's move to our supplement problem.